Hello and welcome everyone to this digital world. I am Ashish Mishra and I will be your guide as we go through this documentary which throws light on digital citizenship, online safety and how to remain safe while working in the digital technology equipped virtual field. Let's begin our journey towards an amazing, invisible and magical world which has no physical existence but has tremendously helped 4.57 billion people around the globe. Let's start off by asking a question. Why do we even need to be digital? What are the benefits of digitalization? Digitalization is needed because it saves time, money, frustrations, increases productivity, is cost efficient, easy to access anytime, anywhere. It is environmental friendly as it saves paperwork and the cost of printing. So, now having read about the various needs and benefits of digitalization, let us now understand what digital citizenship actually means. Digital citizenship literally refers to the responsible use of technology by anyone who uses computers, the internet and digital devices to engage with the society on any level. Now, the question is that, who are digital citizens? So, I want to state here that digital citizens are those persons who use information technology in order to engage in society, politics, government and education. In order to be good digital citizen, one should know how to behave with others properly. They should treat people the way they want to be. One should learn to maintain privacy. One should always try to update himself always. The COVID-19 pandemic has drastically changed the way we live our daily lives. From work to home tradition, online training and learning system has resulted a significant increase in internet data users. According to OpenWorld's Broadband Insights report for first quarter of 2020, average broadband consumption has increased from 273.5 GB last year to 402.5 GB this year. This signifies a huge increase of 47%. So, as the internet has become part of life of all categories of people, including kids, it has become even more essential to save everyone from cybercrimes. As the population of digital citizens is increasing rapidly, attackers are adopting more advanced techniques to commit cybercrimes. So, we need to not only be digital citizens, but aware and sensitized digital citizens. Digital citizenship should be equipped with all the norms of digital safety. Now, the question arises that, what exactly is crime in the cyber world? Well, any criminal activity that targets computer or computer network or network user is called cybercrime. This type of criminal activity is committed by cyber criminals, hackers, or individuals. With the passage of time, hackers have developed various new techniques for committing cyber crimes like phishing scams, whale hijacking, software piracy, online harassment, cyber stalking, invasion of privacy, etc. Let's go somewhat deep to understand how these cyber crimes are committed so that we can be aware of such activities and know how to remain safe. So, first up is phishing. In phishing, hackers create fake sites to trick people and they are so similar to the real ones that it is almost impossible to distinguish between the two. So, to prevent this, we need to check the HTTPS version of sites, which indicates that they are secure and hence we can browse safely without getting trapped in phishing. Next one is veiling. In this, hacker attacks high-level person or organizations such as CEO or executive or a specific important documents and make fake mails, calls or messages targeting that company. To prevent it, we should simply confirm with the person who has mailed to ensure that the message is real or fake. When messaging is replaced by use of calls, this crime comes to be known as vishing. The next common one is man-in-the-middle attack. In this, the hacker intrudes in between the victim and the destination server which is trying to connect and steals all available data. To prevent this too, we should always check the encryption of sites by looking at HTTPS encryption while making payments or dealing with sensitive data. The next one is the most common, which is password attacks. A hacker, in this case, breaks into a website server and then steals the passwords. No matter what the website is, passwords are saved in the form of encryptions. But the hacker uses brute force and dictionary attacks to crack the password and steal information. Therefore, it is always advised to use a strong password comprising of upper and lowercase letters, special characters, numbers, etc., which makes it difficult to crack passwords. The successful cyber attack can have far-reaching implementations. It includes financial losses, theft of intellectual property, loss of trust and confidence of consumers. It can lead to mental depression. So, having seen the types and impacts of cybercrimes, let us now have a glance on the ways to prevent cybercrimes and stay safe online. The cybercrimes can be minimized by updating the computer regularly. It makes much more difficult for the hackers to access the new computer system. Social networking profiles like Facebook, Twitter, WhatsApp should be set to private. There should be secure Wi-Fi networks in home and offices. The last few months have taught each and every citizen of India the importance of internet, social media and online platforms for education, entertainment, information and business. There is always a chance of cyber attack, but one should not be afraid of any kinds of cyber crimes. But one has to fight with all these types of crimes. The advancement in communication technology will go on endlessly, but one has to keep in mind that one day people will have to accept the digital citizenship and our technologies will overcome all types of cybercrimes.